Today the readings for the liturgy are all about forgiveness of sin, gratitude to our Savior, and recognition that for all of us, whether we have committed grave sin, or whether through the grace of God we have been able to stay free of sin, we are indebted. What St. Peter mentions in his first sermons recorded by St. Luke in the Acts of the Apostles, that there's only one name that we can invoke as Savior. Savior from what? Above all, the one thing that can keep us out of heaven forever, sin. It is Jesus who forgives, but it's also Jesus who makes it possible to repair the damage done by sin, to go and walk in the footsteps of Jesus, to help him, to provide resources to continue his work for the salvation of all. How many times that we hear our Lord say in his public ministry, I have come not to save the just, but to save sinners. You mean there are some who can get to heaven without the help of Jesus? No, he doesn't mean that. There's a little bit of pious sarcasm there. Those who are just in their own estimation. But whether they are just in the estimation of God, if they are just in the estimation of the Father without reference to the Savior, is quite another question. Who is numbered among the sinners? And who are loved so much by our Lord that he would die on the cross, if that is what it takes to repair the damage done by sin? We have several examples, very interesting. The first reading from the concerning Nathan's statement to our Lord, what the Lord is doing in forgiving him, he is taking his child, or he's going to keep it very shortly. People say, why didn't he let the child live and enjoy the kingdom? Because the kingdom of heaven is much greater than any political organization. And secondly, as it were, in the question of David was forgiven, but there's also, as it were, some of you cannot go free and do as we please, have to do a little repair work. The child is not guilty of anything there. What the Lord does is take him to heaven. As it were, the enjoyment is that which is measured out by the Father. Not measured in terms of what we have done, but in the prior love that the Son has, that the Father has for those who are born and are destined by him for heaven. We should keep that in mind always. David, as it were, did not continue to weep when he found out that his child, as it were, was dead, was taken to heaven, was not going to have to suffer in purgatory. That brings to us our attention of something that St. Bonaventure said is very important to remember, that the grace of God that is given for the forgiveness of our sins by Jesus, the fruit of his merit on Calvary, includes not the forgiveness of sin committed, but the grace and the strength not to commit sins that come to us that are a form of temptation. That is still greater grace. When we think of what it means in terms of the Immaculate Conception uniquely given to Our Lady, she was preserved and redeemed. No, she did not have sins to forgive. She had no sins to forgive because she had received, as it were, those unique graces from the cross that Jesus reserved only for her. So that's our first point, that when we are dealing with questions of sin, we no longer, as it were, pay attention to all of the different styles of life, all of the different positions that are occupied by various people in prominent in society, in politics, in economics, and all the other things that are valued, especially in this modern world. The first thing, and it is clear, as it were, in David, who repented what he had done, on the adultery, and then as it were the plot, successful to murder the husband. Can you forgive that? It can be forgiven. If we are willing, as it were, for our sins to do penance. It's not true that we cannot do anything good after our sin. We can do some things, we can be humble and plead with our Lord, ask Him to forgive us, and promise Him that we will do all that is necessary in order to make reparation to the dishonor given to the Lord, and the damage done to our soul, and the potential damage that we can have a hand, as it were, in doing to the souls of others because of our position in society, one thing or another, that we have influence on others who would otherwise not offend our Lord. So it is very important that we note these things. When we ask for God's mercy, that means we're willing, as it were, to take a responsibility where we can and work together with our Savior. And people will say, can you expect us to do these things? If you have the help of Our Lady, you can do them. Many, many, many saints, if we think simply of Saint Augustine, who is still a great influence in the once Christian world, in shaping the thought and the reflection of many. He was a great sinner. That's what held him up from baptism. He didn't have the humility to get down on his knees and say that he was no better than the local farmer who worked for him, because his family was fairly prosperous, having a share in one of the big farm organizations in North Africa. So that's the first thing. We see our Lord came, as it were, to save the sinners, those, as it were, who cannot do one thing for themselves, and as here, I'm forgiven, I forgave myself, I go free. We are free to sin, but we do not find the freedom, as it were, to forgive ourselves. That comes to us through Christ. And when we enjoy that, then we can also, as it were, do more, as it were, to repair and to help others repair the damage that has been done by sin. And the second example, the people who are at the bottom of the pit. And here they are, as it were, where our Lord letting them do all of these wonderful things that are normally done for the Savior, for the King, for the Lord of all, who would give His life, a life that we might live. Here the poor, the poor down and outs, disgraced totally by their style of life. She was a professional prostitute, this particular lady. But she said one thing, and our Lord makes mention of it. You believe in me. By itself, it does not forgive you. But with the grace of our Lord, it does. This is what our Lord said, and He gave a little lesson to Simon. He's not exactly amongst those who are just. He did not give our Lord one recognition of His dignity, of His lordship, of His priesthood, above all, as His divinity. Whereas this poor woman, who has nothing, as it were, so speaking in terms of social orders to offer, to get lost someplace, that did for our Lord in a marvelous, stupendous, superlative, transcendent way, all the marks of dignity. Who is this who speaks for her? He is the Savior of the world. He is the eternal Son of God, the beloved of the Father, who so loved us that He, as it were, gave an order to His dearly beloved, only begotten Son, become one of us and share all the difficulties. One thing He didn't do, commit sin. On the contrary, He died for the sins of others. But it is in a special instance He found in this poor woman, who still had, as it were, the good sense, as it were, to recognize that He alone could have been merciful to her, and that through all these signs that she gave to, yes, I know who you are, and I love you very much, because I know you will save me. And our Lord, on the spot, after he explained a few things to Simon, the dignitary who invited him, put on this big supper in a way that humiliated our Lord, forgave this woman. Not as were to go and behave in that fashion anymore, but to follow Jesus. And then the mentions of St. Luke mentions a few people besides Mary Magdalene, and there were many more besides. Some of these people had their own position in a certain type of society, that is that of Herod, but this is the end, what they do with their lives. They spent them for the rest of the time in supporting the work of our Lord and supporting him so that he might be free completely to help others gain heaven. That is the one thing necessary to gain heaven. We should think of that often. It really doesn't mean in the final analysis who wins the next war. We don't want a next war, if possible. The most important thing always is to remain united to Jesus. It doesn't matter if we only are united to him in this world for a short period of time. The important thing is that we will be united to him for forever. All these things are made clear by our Lord. These women, as it were used the graces that he gave them as were to grow in holiness. St. Mary Magdalene is one of the great saints of the church. And all these other women who are mentioned here have we know enough about them to know that they too, as it were, died as saints. Let us be close to Our Lady, ask her to help us to respond to the care and to the love that our Lord has for us. How much did he love me? More than I can calculate. How much did he love you? More than you can calculate. It's not a question of using a material standard such as money, as he gave in the example, but a question of recognizing, I say, our Lord, the suffering he went through, with the knowledge that he was doing it not only for a great number of people taken and global, but for each of us personally. He reflected on in the Garden of Eden the night before he was nailed to the cross to save us. And if we think of that, we think, Kesler, who will be grateful to the greatest extent, the one who has been forgiven much. You have been forgiven much, I have been forgiven much. We will never estimate how much we have been forgiven and how many are the graces and the assistance, how much the assistance our Lord has given to us to be able to walk faithfully in his footsteps. And above all, as it were, even before we get to heaven, to enjoy some of its aspects in partaking of Holy Communion, in uniting ourselves to Jesus and to all of our sufferings with his, that we might be forgiven, and that those, as it were, who need our help, as it were, to find Jesus, would be able to benefit by us. Praise be Jesus and Mary.
Fructum ventris tuum.